Ariel, could you talk a little bit about your summer experience with USA Basketball, what that did for you?
It was amazing. Having the opportunity to wear those three letters across my chest is always a blessing. Just going out there and, you know, representing the country and playing with 11 of the other best players in the country is always a great opportunity.
What memories stick out just from kind of just the cultural experience of everything?
I'd probably say the food. We got to go visit the Kremlin, which is kind of like their White House to them. And we got to do a little shopping and seeing what they like to do and how they live on a daily basis.
What was your favorite food they ate over there, if you had one, if you liked it at all?
I'm not big on trying a bunch of different foods. A lot of their foods, like seafood stuff, had eyes connected to it and all other stuff. And some of my teammates were like, well, all you gotta do is pull it off and eat it. And I was like, no, I'm gonna let you all have that. So I stuck with pretty much like, you know, pizza, pasta, a little McDonald's every here and there to get me through.
Being in that country, how were you guys received as Americans? I mean, things are a little frosty again between, was it a real hospitable type situation?
It was great. Most of the time we spent on the village, Olympic Village, with all the other, you know, countries and whatnot. And, you know, they all love the United States and all the other countries. They wanted to trade gear with us and have, you know, some of our Nike USA gear and just have fun. I mean, they wanted to get to know us and ask what we did on a regular basis and what kind of music we listened to and that kind of stuff.
When you win the ultimate prize over there, how much does it motivate you to kind of come back here and get as far as you can as well?
Oh, it gives you all the motivation in the world. I mean, it's nothing like winning and being able to stand on that podium at the end and, you know, see your flag raise above every other's. I mean, it's just a great way to end something.
What did it do for you personally? I mean, the year didn't end probably the way you would have liked it for yourself. I mean, did you gain some confidence, or I mean, was there any of that sort of stuff to be gained from this experience?
Gain confidence and just, you know, leadership skills from Coach Cole. She did a great job, you know, instilling that in us. And USA Basketball is a thing where you kind of have to put your ego aside, because everyone that comes in there is good and can play, but you have to do what's best for the team. And so, you know, learning from her, playing with Odyssey Sims, another, you know, great point guard, and learning from her also.
Was there much discussion about the tournament game, or you had played against during the tournament? Mm-hmm. Was there much discussion about that game?
Oh, not really. When we all get together, you know, we just have fun. I mean, we act like you're normal 19, 20-year-old girls. We leave all the college stuff and, you know, rivalries and whatnot behind.
So you and Shoni, she didn't give you any grief over that game at all?
Not at all.
Not at all?
She's a shy person, so it took a while, you know, to open up, but I mean, she's a great person. I think we're friends now.
Did you try to work on anything in terms of your game? Was there any things, maybe in that context you can't, but was there anything you tried to do with your play in that setting?
Not really with USA Basketball. I think it's just such a short time span and you really don't have that much time to actually work on something. But, you know, just going out there, being consistent, being mentally strong, because it's a three-week time period, and you know, you got a week of training camp in Colorado Springs, just 2 days, and not tough in that altitude out there. And, you know, just being strong and know that we're playing for a goal and trying to win something.
Have you gotten a chance to look at next year's schedule yet?
I have. I'm excited about it. Coaches have done a great job at, you know, scheduling us some great talent and even some great trips in there too, so I'm looking forward to it.
Any games or trips in particular you're looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to the Bahamas. I think that'd be nice. I've never been, you know, to a place like that before, so I'm looking forward to that. And then, I mean, every game on the schedule is going to be a good one. You know, teams are going to come for us, and we just got to make sure that we bring our A game every time we step on the court.
What's been your initial impressions of the freshmen so far?
Oh, they're great. I mean, we've been having some tough workouts with Coach Taylor, and they've been putting us through things. But, I mean, they don't give up. They play hard. They play hard and pick up. They're getting after it. I mean, anything you could want in a freshman up to this point.
Mercedes specifically came in with a lot of acclaim and stuff. I mean, I imagine you'd heard a lot about her before she came in. How does she compare to what you were reading and stuff?
I mean, what I've heard was right. You know, she's continuing to impress us every single day, and I'm just looking forward to, you know, really getting to play with her, getting to know and see what she's like on the court, because, I mean, having a 6'6 plus player is, you know, a point guard's dream.
What do you have personal goals for yourself at this point in terms of, just, you know, it's a little early, but what's in your mind for what you want to do? for yourself this season?
I just want to lead this team. You know, we've been knocking a door at a Final Four and haven't yet opened it. So, you know, that's our main goal this year. We're trying to get to Nashville, and every day we're working to get better collectively as a group to get there.
What's the biggest difference in you as a player now versus maybe this time a year ago? What do you think you've improved on the most?
I think I'm more mature. You know, understanding what Coach Willick wants and what the new coaching staff wants, and, you know, just doing my best to instill that in my teammates and making sure that I'm consistent. You know, I'm setting an example for all the young ones.
You mentioned Coach Taylor. What's he been like so far? I mean, what's your impressions of him in terms of what he's trying to do with you guys?
Intense. Every time we step in, you know, the weight room or on the court with him or on the football field, we know he's going to get everything out of us, and that's not going to be easy, but we're all aware of the big picture, and that in the end it's going to pay off for us.